Tesla Model 3 and Model Y will now detect and slow down for emergency vehicle. Here is a new code that is now new in Tesla owner's manual. If Model 3, Model Y detects lights from an emergency vehicle when using Autosteer at night on a high-speed road, the driving speed is automatically reduced and the touchscreen displays a message informing you. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from torquenews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle news discussions and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. And please give us thumbs up for this video, like it, share in social media if you find this information helpful. Simon Alvarez, just hours ago in Tesla Radio, wrote Tesla's software update 2021.24.12 seems to include something noteworthy and very interesting for the Model 3 and Model Y. While the software update's release notes were identical to previous updates in the way that they highlight features like Disney Plus streaming and car wash mode, 2021.24.12 also included something that would likely make the Model 3 and Model Y even safer on the road, especially when it comes to full self-driving. As per observations of a Tesla owner on Twitter, who tweets at Analytics ETH, who was able to view the 2021-24-12 owner's manual for the Model 3 and Model Y, a particularly interesting section on how Autosteer responds to emergency vehicles has been added by the company. Unlike its previous iterations, the 2021.24.12 owner's manual for the Model 3 and Tesla Model Y now states that Autosteer would automatically reduce a vehicle's speed when an emergency vehicle is detected. She points to this new text in Tesla 2021.24.12 owner's manual for Model 3 and Model Y, saying that the text reads like this, quote, "If Model 3, Model Y detects lights from an emergency vehicle when using Autosteer at night on a high-speed road, the driving speed is automatically reduced and the touchscreen displays a message informing you of the slowdown. You will also hear a chime and see a reminder to keep your hands on the steering wheel. When the light detects pass by or cease to appear, Autopilot resumes your cruising speed. Alternatively, you may tap the accelerator to resume your cruising speed," Tesla noted in this new owner's materials. A look at the updated owner's manual shows that the company is still emphasizing that drivers must be fully aware and vigilant when operating features like Autosteer and Autopilot. While the Model 3 and Model Y are now capable of slowing down for emergency vehicles, which is certainly good news, drivers must still be ready to take over if needed. Tesla was also careful to highlight that the feature would likely not be perfect and thus it must be used cautiously. Here's what Tesla added to the owner's manual regarding the imperfection of the feature. Quote, "Never depend on autopilot features to determine the presence of emergency vehicles. Model 3 and Model Y may not detect lights from emergency vehicles in all situations. Keep your eyes on your driving path and always be prepared to take immediate action," Tesla wrote new in this latest owner's manual for Model 3 and Model Y. Friends, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, NHTSA, has launched an investigation on driver assist systems like Tesla's autopilot system. More recently, the NHTSA expanded its investigation by requesting information from 12 other manufacturers that employ driver assist systems on their vehicles. Automakers included in the NHTSA's expanded list include BMW, Honda, Hyundai, Toyota, Ford, Nissan, Stellantis, Kia, Volkswagen, General Motors, Mercedes-Benz, and even Subaru. I think the next 12 months, we will see a dramatic improvement of the capabilities of Tesla's autopilot. Because the previous 12 months have been already great improvements. Tesla Autopilot is moving to a single AI model stack for all types of roads by version 10.1, and Tesla have already removed the radar input that created more noise than actionable information in their AI driver model. Tesla also got a brand new AI training supercomputer installed that uses NVIDIA's chip that is 4 times faster than their previous NVIDIA supercomputer, and Dojo looks to take over within another 4 times jump in speed by next year. It is an exciting time to be a Tesla owner, especially if you have full self-driving, some people say. Tesla is already saving lives with Autopilot, and many more lives will be saved when Autopilot gets more capable. Because we humans are fallible, we make mistakes, we make errors. Technology usually does not, but there is the other dangers. Tim Kulogo comments under Tesla Radi saying, every 12 months we have seen a dramatic improvement of the capabilities of Tesla Autopilot. I think the thing that caught us off guard is how much it can improve each year and still not be driving itself. Self-driving cars aren't just an impossible task. This is not an impossible task, but a chain of impossible tasks that we can't even see the end of. We'd never get anywhere without a company like Tesla doing 6 impossible things before breakfast each morning, I guess, huh? Well, regarding emergency vehicles, there is a proposal by the Tesla community, people enthusiastic about Tesla, that discuss under Tesla Radi's article. For example, how about someone making emergency vehicles that with radio beacons to notify their presence and state of emergency status? Seems pretty simple to me, right? In fact, use a number of carrier frequencies to distinguish between different types of emergency services and different types of emergency vehicles. This is impossible. Or use multiple beacons on a vehicle for redundancy. Use frequencies that are relevant short range to avoid that actually are relatively short range to avoid confusion from multiple sources. Use a receiver that is a phased array so can determine the direction of the beacon and resolve multiple beacons simultaneously. Use a frequency all the current driving solutions are already compatible with, both the electronic and wetware driving software. These things can help Tesla vehicles and future other electric self-driving vehicles from other companies to determine emergency services. A lot of emergency vehicles already have traffic light beacons, GPS tracking, etc., etc. How hard would it be to either have them add a universal vehicle status, position, etc. beacon that could either be picked up by approaching cars or, better still, be taken by Tesla and added to the maps of cars in the area, a bit like traffic congestion, etc. This could then be used to divert people away from road incidents too, and could also be used to tell cars on AP to pull out of the overtaking lane before an emergency vehicle catches up with them. The benefits of this would be really huge and save time and therefore save lives. Is this a lot to ask? Some people say yes, and they point out to the cost, and also they point is that 5G development of internet, it is doable if 5G exists, I guess, but the money involved would be very expensive and it would still only work in areas that have 5G. There are probably 1 million emergency vehicles in the United States, if not more, with some of those being privately owned. Others say it would take 20 years to roll out to all vehicles from the day all new vehicles are required to have such a system. That is what makes it hard, and it will be very high cost, but look how much is being invested already in transforming our driving experience. Also, the legal process of deciding on such a system could take years. I'm not saying it can't be done, just that it will take at least, I guess, several years, if not more, if we start working on getting it done today. Well, in the meantime, I guess it's good that Tesla Model 3 and Model Y electric vehicles will now detect and slow down for emergency vehicles. Here's a new code that is now in Tesla's annual owner's manual that I shared with you. Let me know, guys, what you think about all these things and these things improving now Tesla Model 3 and Model Y determining emergency vehicles on road and slowing down for them. This is Armin Haryan from torquenews.com. Please give us thumbs up for this video. Let's continue the discussion in the comment section. I'll look forward to hearing your opinions. And also please share this video in social media. That would greatly appreciate it. And also subscribe to our channel. I'll see you soon in our next report. God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you. And have a great day. See you soon today.